wavelengths which is present with outer sides of the seed are get contacted with the soil and get stick to the soil. So from here we can get delinted cotton seeds. Means there is no presence of fiber. All the small fibers is removed by this soil. It's around 176 in number. They may be vary according to size and capacity of machine, but on average basis, there are 176 soils and seeds are come from the top and put into the machine, and with the help of this soil, the small lints are get collected on the hands of the soils and lints are removed and we get the delinted cotton seeds. Now the brushes, the role of brushes are there. This is brush. Brushing will be fitted opposite sides of the soil. Difficult to draw on the board. Opposite side of the back side of the machine, and a air blower is there. A big air blower is there. The role of air blower is to remove this lint to the brushing and gets outside the machine. Get it from outside. Soil brushing, then after brushing it is sent to the duct with the help of big fan or by air circulation, because these lints are very lightweight and small in size. Okay, this is again the byproduct. Delinting. These small lints are useful in the textile industries or to produce the soft cotton products. Soft cotton or delicate cotton products. Delinting is covered. Now we have the cotton seed. That is first step is covered. Delinted cotton seed. Now this is same for dehulling. We need to remove the hulls. In second stage, it's dehulling or decortication. Decortication means breaking the seed in 4 to 5 different parts. That is known as mainly decortication. Before that, we want to focus on dehulling. Oil is present in oil cells inside the seed in the form of emulsion, and there is no need of hull. Is there? There is no oil is present in the hulls. So we need to remove for purification. Hulls will be removed in dehulling operation. It is sent for the dehuller. In dehuller, the outer surface of our delinted cotton seed is get removed, and now our cotton seed is break into two parts. Delinted cotton seed. Now our delinted cotton seed is break into two parts. That is, one is hulls, and second one is flesh. Second one is flesh of seed. Required for our main product to extract the oil. Hulls is again a byproduct. This is same for the. This is hulls is quite useful. Hulls of cotton seed is quite useful in nuclear power plant. Right now I don't remember the exact application of that hulls, but it is quite useful in nuclear power plant. And this flesh of seed we get here. This is a very delicate operation, decortication. To cut the seed in 4 or 5 parts. This is your seed. To cut it in 4 or 5 parts. This is your hull. Just outer surface. It should be removed. and this is the actual center part of your seed flesh. Flesh, seed flesh, that is oil content. So it should be carefully decorticated. There is a strong precaution or supervision on to not to powder the seeds, not to powder the seeds. Because if they are powdered totally, then the oil loss will be there. The oil cell get ruptured and break down at the same position of decortication. Even our mechanical extraction, solvent extraction is far away. There are 4 or 5 different stages are still required to go on. Now in second stage we get dehulled cotton seed. Dehulled cotton seed. Now same for the roller mills or grinding. Roller mills of grinding. I just remove it. Roller mills. Our third step is. Why there is a need of this pre-treatment roller mill or grinding operation? Grinding operation is necessary in cotton seed oil pre-treatment because it can increase your surface area. By grinding, the surface area of seed gets increased and size of seed get more and more smaller, but the surface area of seed will be increased. There is a one statement regarding the surface area, because after grinding the oil cells present in the oil seed. This is your oil seed, this is your cotton seed oil seed, cotton oil seed, this is your cotton oil seed, and this is the outer surface area. Here what it may contain is protein, phospholipids, glycolipids, major area, oil cells, moisture, flesh of oil. It's a complete composition. It's difficult to say that where is exactly oil cells are kept, because oil is present in the oil seed in the form of emulsion, and it's a strong emulsion with protein. So just consider that this is the area of seed where the oil cells are present. These are the various oil cells. Just consider this is the seed before the operation of roller mills. This is the actual seed. Just we are getting it from after dehulling or decortication. So this is the area of, just assume it, this is the area where the oil is kept inside the seed, and these are the oil cells. Now when it's sent to the roller mills, in roller milling it is crushed. It is going for crushing. Instead of using a crushing oil, it is going for grinding. In grinding what happened, the seeds are goes from the inside of the rollers. It is passed from the inside of roller. Roller is just like far. They are not that much far. This is the diagram of two-pass roller. The difference between these two rollers is higher in first pass. This is your first pass. And the difference is quite lower. This is your second pass. So oil seeds are come from here. This is your hopper. From here, they are come here and get crushed or grind. After that, they come for the second pass, and from second pass we are gated just like a length, quite higher in length but smaller in size, that is grinded seeds. So the diameter of the roller is around 200 to 400 mm, and the thickness, that is the, it's difficult to draw the roller, but the width of the roller is around 1000 mm. There is a one statement related to this grinding operation, that is if the surface area of your oil seeds, more will be the amount of oil extracted. That is, if surface area of an oil seed is higher, then extracted quantity of oil is also higher. So it definitely increase your yield percentage. So if we can skip this operation, our yield will be lower. We don't get that much quantity of oil for our oil seeds. If it contains around 15 to 24% of oil in oil seed, and if we can skip this roller mills or grinding operation, then definitely the yield is our very good. We not get that much quantity of oil as a product. Beside that, there are different advantages of grinding mills. Just like it is easier to make the extraction process, it can make the extraction process easier. It can give, earlier told that higher amount of yield is used, higher amount of yield is provided, and the last one is